when you hear President Akufo-Addo say that go to court, ex ante judicial powers are not vested in the president. You don't preach human rights and tell the person that go and recover the right in court. That's not the proper way to exercise executive authority. And therefore, the president is accordingly reminded that his powers and the constitutions are subject to the laws of Ghana, subject to the constitution of Ghana, and subject to he respecting the fundamental rights and freedoms of Ghanaians, including the right of any Ghanaian to own an excavator. It's a right. Maybe you people haven't even explored it further. It's a right. Right to ownership, to own an excavator. And I'm not aware of any law in Ghana which permits burning of excavators. If you cannot identify the person driving it, go to the port who brought it in. And probably to improve it, we should now add that any person clearing an excavator must sign an undertaking that it will not be used for purposes of illegal mining. Then when he is in breach of it, or you come to Parliament for us to give you the mandate to ban excavators. But as at this morning, we have not clothed any president of Ghana with powers to ban excavators. I find that an exercise in excess of the president's power. And he is not above the law. He is not above the constitution of Ghana. He is to fight gallantly.
I have no qualms in my mind. Look, what is an excavator supposed to be used for? Dredging, in the construction of roads. But in the construction of roads, the excavator as an equipment is the least used equipment. For what? One is just for the excavation of drains. And if they have to build bridges, use it to excavate to dredge the stream before they construct the bridges. That's what they use them for. How can we have in this country excavators now numbering over 5,000? What are they using them for? Last week, on my way to Kumasi, at Asaman Tamfoye, the community before, that is from Accra, before Enyinem, when we got there, we saw an excavator on a low loader that was branching off into one village, and the whole population in the village had come out and were shouting, "Walk on here, walk on here." What are they doing? I want to know what they are doing with it. Today, streams feeding rivers have been diverted and hugely polluted. Look, if you dig the topsoil 2 feet, it takes 200 years for the soil to replenish itself. If you dug 100 meters, the past 10 years, we have lost 500,000 hectares of forest cover. Today, as we speak, the forest cover of this country is less than 600,000 hectares. Where are we going as a country? And we think these activities should not be stopped. I beg to disagree, the Honorable Minority Leader. I beg to disagree.